Yes, sir.
Sorry for the delay, everybody. I'd like to call to order Forsyth County Board of Commissioners work session for Tuesday, September 27th, 2011, at 2:13 p.m. All commissioners are present.
In governmental budgeting, when you come to the end of the year, December 31st, all budgets lapse, meaning whatever's remaining is gone. It's done. It doesn't carry over in any way, shape, or form. It's over. The next day, January 1, our fiscal year, the new budget begins. And that's fine, pretty clear to understand. However, the normal course of business is, as we get toward the end of the fiscal year, there's commitments outstanding. There's purchase orders where the items haven't been delivered. There's projects, construction going on where the item is not finished. Here's where the budget rule is going to bump up against the accounting rule. When those items are delivered in January, February, the construction project is finished in the new year, that gets recorded as an expense or expenditure in the new year. What that means for a department, let's say the department has ordered a $5,000 piece of equipment toward the end of this fiscal and calendar year. When it's delivered in January, and there's no choice, this is a very firm accounting, but when it's delivered in January, you record the expense then. So the total judicial system, looking at the bottom line here, just looking at percentages, is a 4.15% increase in the general fund. Again, some of that is grant funded. On the next page, two more sections here. Total general government is up 17.33%, and part of this is some operating expenses. I think it's in the professional service areas and administration. And if I don't want to comment on that, or that is the area of professional services, I think, to provide some things that the board may want the county manager to look at.
That's exactly what it is. The majority of that, if not all, of the increase is for management professional services. We've got a lot of projects coming up next year, and we want to have some funding there to utilize those funding for professional services to help us with the project.
So we come to the total for the general fund and the expenditure side of $92,449,264, or 4.86% above 2011 budget.
Is that percentage for the library?
And this over here, we got too many zeros. Is it the formatting?
No, I think it's pretty much the.
It might be that we added, what was it, 150, 160,000? And it was very small before we added that.
That's the
law library.
Their budget's usually really small.
Yeah, that was very small, but when we add that reserve for contingency for the amount of cash that is available. So we simply want to make the cash available.
Increase the budget to the library.
Yeah. We don't want the non-law library to get excited about that.
Item number 4 is the Director of Personnel Services.
Yes, Commissioners, I have several housekeeping items relating to the 2012 benefits that the board has previously approved, and these are, some of them came up during the approval process, and others are a few things that we still have some time to go over. In the work session that the board did approve, the 2012 benefits. One of the things that the board did ask for is that a communication be provided to all employees regarding the long-term disability benefit information specific to the buy-up option. That information was released to all of the employees on August 26th, and I've gotten solid feedback from employees that they felt that was very timely and helpful to them, and they understood that aspect of the buy-up for the long-term disability. In addition, we also have, as of actually yesterday, we did release a 2012 employee benefit open enrollment schedule. I'll pass these out to you. I know this was also of concern to the board as far as availability of meetings.
Have you come up with any cost to this plan?
I have reached out to the brokers, and to get very solid numbers, you would have to go to an actuary, which runs the money. But we felt that we could get a fairly solid cost estimate based upon our net annualized cost, or cost per employee, where we currently are at, and based upon a typically a conservative 8% increase annually on cost increases for health care, we were able to at least look at, well, in the past, since 2009, how many elected officials have left that would have been eligible. And we basically had 6 that have left office since 2009. Basically, the base rate would be approximately 283,000, but it would be compounded on top of that if others were to be added on that.
So 1 and 2 are the same thing, you're just saying 2 would apply to just the board of commissioners?
Correct. Correct. Oh, that's not sure what the desire of the board is.
We have a motion for a second.
Second discussion.
Second for discussion.
I don't really think Medicare is a valid insurance.
I'm not sure. It's in the packet, that's why I said it. I'm sure.
So your motion was just bring back an agreement to that, wouldn't you?
I think we're going to need to come back. The standard commercial true reservation agreement is only 50 hours per day.
Is that right?
We have to put it on motion.
It'll come back in the contract. Yeah, I'll bring it back.
Does that have to come back to us?
Any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye. Those like sign. There are none.
The declarant, which is Bridgepoint, shall not utilize the subject property, which is their property, to organize or assemble for the conducting of, within the Crystal Cove Shores subdivision, off-premise active proselytizing, parenthetical, meaning face-to-face solicitation or direct telephone solicitation, on behalf of any particular religion or denomination. This is what Bridgepoint has agreed to. And I just need a motion and second to approve the covenant so I can get it to Bridgepoint for execution.
Just clarification.
Oh, well, yeah, Commissioner Amos, you just need to be quiet, and your recusal will continue from your
Does he need to make any sort of statement?
Well, just I think the record should reflect that he was recused previously, and he continues that recusal now.
Okay. Well, then I note that for the record, that Commissioner Amos is going to recuse himself from the action taken on the side.
I would, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we approve the declaration of restrictions, covenants, and conditions made and entered into as of the first day of September 2011 by Bridgepoint Community Networks.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
No second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, like sign. There are none. That motion passes 4-0, with Commissioner Amos having voluntarily recused himself.
Thank you, Commissioner. I appreciate it. Thank
you. Okay.
But explain again what you want to limit to those zoning ordinances.
Any meeting place for a nonprofit organization.
Well, scouts.
That's going to be tough.
Yeah, I mean, heck, there's a cattle association. They meet in people's homes and things like that.
No. As an institutionalized place of meeting, it's always at this one place.
going to be a tough one still, you know, that we, you have to be real creative, I think.
I mean, if they continue to meet at one place, you're against that.
They could even do it privately. What I'm saying is we won't grant them a zoning or a cup or anything else that institutionalizes that.
I think what he's trying to get at, it goes back to the Bridgeport is. But I don't think it would affect the Boy Scout type thing because you're not looking to get a cup.
He's nonprofit. He said nonprofit.
Yeah, he's going to have to word a little bit differently.
But there is no, I'm not aware of a Boy Scout place meeting hall that exists in a neighborhood.
What churches?
I did the meetings in my house.
Churches are also nonprofit, and I think they should be limited to CBD and office industrial in the future.
I mean, but can't churches go on agriculture?
Now with a cup.
Conditionally.
Conditionally, yeah. So they, so that would change that. You'd have to change our UDC to reflect that.
Commissioners, how would that affect our being able to rent out our senior centers for nonprofit leanings?
I believe we're not subject to our own rules for that. Well, there are a lot of things that ought to be.
But I know Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts, Patrick, don't you believe?
I'm trying to think of the individual Brewster's account as part of the nonprofit for the organization. You'd have to think this one through a lot and get through. You might want to tell Ken.
You have different foundations.
Yeah, you got different foundations. You got a lot of nonprofit things that you just can't see. You got to meet the commercial building.
They can't all afford it or rent it.
Yeah.
Or use it. However, our Parks and Recs have a lot of facilities now.
Okay, again, in the interest of time, if it's okay, I think if this were to pass,
sit down with Ken.
If this were to pass, it would go to the public hearing calendar. Is that correct, Counselor?
It would, but I think I would like to get a little guidance, just because I want to make sure I know where you're going. If you're truly going,
why don't you sit down with Ken and bring us back in 2 weeks?
I'm not sure we know where we're going. That's why I was going to say maybe we postpone this to the next agenda when we've had some time to. Item number 18, County Attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this is a fairly simple housekeeping matter, and this is quite frankly just to help our county clerks have a record. At a December 3rd, 2009 BOC meeting, we revised section 1.3H of the alcohol code to provide that a license issued for the sale of distilled spirits by the packaged any outlet located within 100 feet from any child care center would be authorized, regardless of whether the child care center satisfied the requirements of state law. These are requests for annexations from the city of Cumming. Let's take up the north side hospital one first.
Discussion, please. What is there, does anybody know what the reason is for wanting the annexes?
Cheaper water.
Well, besides cheaper water.
You know, I don't know. You have in your package, you have the actual application for the property owner that has come forward seeking it.
Some people find it easier to work in the city than Ken.
Well, we're trying to work on that. I know you're right. For permitting and such. I mean, because obviously we lose all those permitting fees and the impact fees.
I don't know. I mean, they don't have, all they have an obligation to do is what they provided in this
form. I'm just curious if someone would come to want to do some kind of big project for the amenity.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry, Counselor Steinbeam.
Let's come back fast.
We need 5 minutes in an executive session.
Okay. We'll come back on this clock. Which clock do you want to go by this time?
Let's go by this at 5 o'clock.
The one in my car.
Not the one that you were buying for the meeting store.
That's right. One city clock and one county clock. We'll go by this clock here. We'll be back at 5 o'clock.